Massimo Vignelli, I'm a designer. I live in New York. I came from Milano to begin with. And I've been working since 1955. So that makes it 50, almost 55 years. And we work on the whole field of design, so there's never a dull moment. You know, we work on graphic design, we work on packaging, we work on books and other editorial things, books, magazines, newspapers. Then we work on the interiors and furniture, we work on product design, the whole thing. And as I said, never a dull moment. And the way of working has changed tremendously in the last 20 years, with the advent of the computer. Before that, it seems to me, was medieval situation somehow. You know, when I started to work, type, you know, in typography, for instance, type was made with lead, you know, and then became phototype, then it became computer type. You know. So you see, you know, the technological advances in the last 50 years have been tremendous. And along with that, you know, the way of working. However, the discipline was already established. Somehow, sometimes it looks like that the discipline of design that we have been using was nothing but the preparation for the advent of more sophisticated technologies and working processes. Including the computer. You know, we've been working with grids, we've been working with the simplification of type in general, simplification of typography in general, and all those things are still valid even in the computer here. Now, in terms of design, I think the computer has made the possibility of achieving fabulous typography much more than ever before in the last 500 years. But at the same time, has also allowed people to do the worst things ever. You know, it's a funny instrument. And it's amazing, even with a computer, very often you find, God, it's so slow. Compared to what? You know, compared to the times that we started. When we were working and cutting the type, one letter from the other, just to put it together, unbelievable. Gluing all these things, you know, I lost a few letters. You know. Now you can do with a computer anything you want. You can do great, great design today. And I think it was much better than in the past because we were conditioned by materials which were very were like a tempera. If you want a darker color background, tempera. Now you just push a button and you get the whole field, you know, tinted in any color you want to. It might not be as good as you like to have it, perhaps because the computer and the printers have limitations. But what you do instead of any incredibly sensitive shade of the color, you just go for what the computer can do. And there is always a way to adapt it to a language and be lyrical about that. So you can make poetry with anything if you want. Everyone goes where his wares can be sold better, you know, or where there is a need. I always say, the guy with the pushcart selling his hot dog on the corner, and if he can't sell his hot dogs in that corner, he's not going to stay there. He just moves to a more profitable corner. Now, I grew up in Italy, and very quickly reached the ceiling there, you know, the famous there, and so on and so forth. But after a while that you're there, you know, everybody likes you, everybody praises you, you get all the best jobs there. You want to measure yourself where in a place where the city is, you know, higher perhaps. You know. So that was one of the incentives to move to New York. I thought the city was higher in New York. I was wrong. There is no city in New York. So we started Unimark in 1965. with that kind of intention of bringing a certain kind of design to large corporations. We had the idea at the time, large corporations were using very trivial kind of communication in a sense. So only small companies here and there could do some good, you know, with good graphic designers in a sense. So what we wanted to do to affect the environment, we wanted to work with large corporations. So we set up a large corporation so we could be at level with the large clients, you know. And just because we had experience before that as a small individual, we couldn't reach the large clients. Now, that helped us to grow very fast and to have the impact that we had. You know, we started with four offices, New York, Milano, New York, Chicago, and San Francisco, four offices. And then we had, when we were getting large clients, like Ford, the corporate identity for Ford Motor Cars, we had to have an office in Detroit, then we had a big client in Denver, so we had another office in Denver, in Cleveland. So the idea was to spread a language of design, and along with that, it's funny enough, you know, the Helvetica typeface was done in 1957, and then and I started to use it, you know, finally had it available to use in 1960. So by 1965, I already knew how to play that instrument very well, I must say. 1965, there was no Helvetica in America, so I ordered. But since we had four or five offices, I immediately spread it around the country, because I was using just Helvetica at the time. Helvetica, Garmin, and Bondoli, that's it. I never used anything else, so to speak. And so the type became very, very popular immediately throughout the world, but particularly throughout America, because of our, you know, input into that thing. Along with the type, of course, the type was based on a particular type of graphic structure with values of kind, you know, in terms of size and space and so on. So it was the perfect word for a certain language, in a sense, that we want to do. Our approach to design has always been as an organization of information instead of, you know, we don't think graphic design is an art to begin with. We don't think design is an art to begin with. It's design. And I think it's noble enough not to have to borrow from the other field, you know, the qualification. But as a matter of fact, the more design goes toward art, the less design it is, you know. And art, the same thing, the more it goes toward design, the less artistic it is. So you can see that design is there to solve problems, is there to be just like doctors, you know, they're there to solve problems. We are the problems. The good advantage is that a bad designer doesn't kill anybody. A bad doctor could.